हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
ओम नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
ओम नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय। हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय। ओम नमः शिवाय, हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
ओम नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, हर हर
भोले नमः शिवाय। कोटेश्वराय शिव कोटेश्वराय, हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
कोटेश्वराय शिव कोटेश्वराय, हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
कोटेश्वराय शिव कोटेश्वराय, हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
कोटेश्वराय शिव
शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
ओम नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
रामेश्वराय शिव रामेश्वराय, हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
रामेश्वराय शिव रामेश्वराय,
हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय। नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
जयता दराय शिव जयता दराय हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
जयताधराय शिव जयताधराय हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
जयताधराय शिव जयताधराय हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय। शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
सोमेश्वराय शिव सोमेश्वराय हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
सोमेश्वरा शिव सोमेश्वरा हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
सोमेश्वराय शिव सोमेश्वराय हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
सोमेश्वरा शिव
शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर बोले नमः शिवाय।
ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः
हर भोले हर हर भोले हर हर भोले नमः
वस्तु अमोल मेरा सत्य गुरु Oh,
शिव नाम से है जगत में उजाला, हरि भक्तों के है मन में शिवा शंभु बाबा मेरे भोलेनाथ, तीनों लोक में तू ही तू। शंभु बाबा मेरे भोलेनाथ, तीनों लोक में तू ही तू। श्रद्धा सुमन मेरा मन बिल पत्री, जीवन भी अर्पण कर दूं। शंभु बाबा मेरे भोलेनाथ, तीनों लोक तू ही तू। स्वामी है तू, अंतर्यामी है तू, मेरे जीवन की अनमिट कहानी है तू। जय भोलेनाथ, जय भोलेनाथ, जय भोलेनाथ, जग का स्वामी है तू, अंतर्यामी है तू, मेरे जीवन की अनमिट कहानी है तू। तेरी शक्ति अपार, तेरा पावन है द्वार, तेरी पूजा मेरा जीवन आधार। शंभु बाबा मेरे भोलेनाथ, तीनों लोक में तू ही तू। है कामना और कुछ जानू ना, जिंदगी भर करूं तेरी आराधना। जय भोलेनाथ, जय भोलेनाथ, जय भोलेनाथ। मन में है कामना और कुछ जानू ना, जिंदगी भर करो तेरी आराधना। सुख की पहचान दे तू मुझे ज्ञान दे, प्रेम सबसे करो ऐसी पहचान दे। तूने दिया है निर्बल को बल, अज्ञानी को ज्ञान दिया। शंभु बाबा मेरे भोलेनाथ, तीनों लोक में तू ही तू। जय भोलेनाथ, जय भोलेनाथ,
शंकर महाराज की जय।
Please join with us as we chant the Shiva Mana Stotra.
Dhani
Hare Om. as we participate in meditation. First, we'll chant Om three times. Your hands on back of your palms on your knees, sitting up straight. Please join with us as we participate in silent meditation. To deliver this message. Hopefully I can do justice to it. Today I would like to talk about Hanumanji. Some of you might know that this is one of my favorites. Because most of us can relate to him, and he represents selfless service. Hanuman is surely the most popular of the Hindu deities, and his chalisa is chanted the most out of all of them. And he's the most common murti in homes and many of our places of worship. When we think of Hanuman, we must realize that he is revered because he is a servant of Bhagavan Ram. His claim to divinity is due to his good karma and his great philosophy of service before the self is a great one. Some of his most famous representations of service are depicted in paintings and murtis and the stories we tell of him. Today, I would like to talk about some of these depictions of Hanuman and the good qualities that he represents. The first representation that I would like to touch upon is his humility and his willingness to serve. One of my most favorite stories of Hanuman and his willingness to serve is when Ram returns back to Ayodhya to rule the kingdom. All was well and the kingdom was at peace, but Hanuman was distressed. He wasn't happy because he felt like he was unable to serve the Lord. Now, this is a rare quality to find. Most of us complain that we have too much work to do, and we really beg to serve others. After hearing of his distress, Ram also became distressed, and this was his closest devotee. He had to help him, so he decided to give Hanuman a task. The task that he gave him was to snap his fingers every time Prabhu Ram sneezed. Now, this is an odd task, but Hanuman immediately became happy because he was asked to do something. So he wondered to himself, how could he fulfill this task? So he decided that he would snap his fingers all day long until Ram was ready to sneeze. Now, something so simple made him so happy. So devout was Hanuman that he was ready to do anything. The smallest task, he would complete it to the best of his ability. His willingness to serve is shown in his never-ending desire to serve the Lord. Another thing that Hanuman shows us is how to serve. Many of you know the Ram Dawar Murthy, and we have one right here. In this representation of Hanuman, he's kneeling and on his knees, and he has his hands clasped, and he's bowing in front of the Lord. This shows us that he's always ready to serve, and he's always praising the Lord. This is a quality that we should all look forward to. We should be ready to serve the Lord and humanity at all times. Another example of selfless service of Hanuman is that he puts his life at risk for the opportunity to serve Prabhu Ram. This is altruism, selflessness, and caring for others without any care for yourself. We are all familiar with the Murti of Hanuman carrying the Dholagiri mountain, as you see on my left. Here Hanuman was asked to bring the Sanjeevani herb, or the leaf of life, to heal Lakshman from his injuries. He went without hesitation or question and returned with more than what was requested of him. Hanuman was only asked to bring back the herb, but instead he brought back the whole mountain. He did this because he decided it was taking too long to bring the leaves and the Lord was waiting for him. So he picked up the mountain and flew. During his journey, he did not stop at once to think about his own life and the dangers that he was putting himself in. He put his own needs aside and was totally selfless in his service to Ram. Another quality that I spoke about before was he's helpful to those in need. Another example was when he went to help Mother Sita when she was held captive in Lanka, and he brought hope to her. He represents the ideal messenger here because he delivers a message with all the love and feelings of the sender being Prabhu Ram. His words of advice and his presence gave Mother Sita strength and courage to endure the punishment of her captors. And ultimately, he was instrumental in returning her back to Prabhu Ram. He yet again is showing his selflessness by journeying into Lanka, a city of Rakshasas and the most powerful of the Rakshasas, Ravan. And he did this by himself, and he did it in order to find Mother Sita and to give her comfort. In all of the representations that I've given you examples of, one thing that you should have noticed is that in his selfless service, he always has no expectations for himself. Never did he ever ask for anything, and he didn't ask for anything in return. He is a student of dharma, or duty, a teacher to the world and a servant to Prabhu Ram. He is a true example of a karma yogi. Karma yoga is selfless action. It is when we perform actions without the desire of receiving anything in return. In chapter 3 of the Bhagavad Gita, on karma yoga, there is a verse that exemplifies the actions of Hanuman. Before I read it, I'd like to chant the Gita Dhyanam, so please join with me. Krishna replies to Arjuna in his question about karma yoga in verse 8. Niyatam kuru karma tvam karma jayoha hya karma nah sharir yatrapi chate na prasidha yedha akarma nah Shri Krishnaya Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo Namah. In this verse, Lord Krishna is saying to engage yourself in dutiful action and to never be inactive. Karma is action. Akarmana is inaction. And what he's saying is that you should always do actions with a purpose. And it to not be lazing around, being lethargic, and not engaging in anything. One analogy that he gives is the story of a serpent and a garden that he was protecting. There was this snake, and there was a fruit tree in this garden, and the snake was upset because all the people were taking the fruits from the tree and they weren't taking care of it. And so the snake decided to take it upon himself to protect this tree. So he decided to hiss and to bite the people that were coming into the garden. And the people were getting sick, so they decided to do something about it. So one day a Swami comes to the village, and the people talk to the Swami. So the Swami decides to talk to the snake. And so the Swami goes to the garden, and he asks the snake, "Why are you doing this? Why are you biting these people?" And the snake says, "Well, if I don't do it, then this tree will suffer, and all the fruits it bears will be ridden of, and we will have no fruits to share." So the snake took it upon himself to take action and to bite the people. So the Swami asked him to not hurt the people. So the snake decided to comply, and he said, okay, fine, I'll do what you ask of me. So days go by, and the Swami returns to the garden, and then he finds the snake beaten up in a hole, nearly dying. And and the Swami asked him, what happened? What's going on? And the snake replied, and he said, this is what you told me to do. You told me not to protect the tree. And the Swami said, no, I said to not hurt them, but I didn't say you couldn't hiss. And this is the difference between dutiful action and inactiveness. The snake, by doing nothing, he gained nothing. If you do something with a purpose, then you will gain something. And that's exactly what Hanuman is doing. He's serving the Lord with a purpose, and he's always ready to serve. He's never found doing nothing at all. He's always looking for something to do. He represents immeasurable mental strength and courage, which are key qualities that are required to be a good servant. He is the doorway to getting closer to God, which is service. Service is the key to the doorway of the Lord. Ram Duwari Tumra Kavari. That's a verse from the Chalisa, which is saying, you are protecting the doorway to God. So how can we be like Hanuman? Well, we need to learn to be humble, and we need to develop our skills in how to be of service to others. We need to be helpful to others without any expectations for our service. So that is the conclusion of my short message. So, actually, one thing I wanted to mention, our youth group, this ties into karma yoga, our selfless duties. We have a food drive, and I've noticed there's not that much food in in the bin. So we're trying to collect food, and what is our goal again? 1,000 pounds. So please help our youth in collecting the food and becoming good karma yogis. On one other thing, we have our announcements. So Sunday, the pretty poach was sponsored by Ramander, so let's give us a hand. And I mentioned the food drive. So we're collecting a non-perishable vegetarian food. The food can be dropped off in the white barrel that's right at the front. And there's a bin, and I think we've decorated it so you can see it. 1,000 pounds is our goal, and we need it by December 18th. We need macaroni and cheese, peanut butter, and canned fruits and rice. So if you have any of those